हेलो एवरीवन, लेट अस सी प्रिंटिंग ऑफ कॉटन बाय यूजिंग रिएक्टिव डाइज। नाउ रिएक्टिव डाइज, दिस बिलोंग टू डिफरेंट केमिकल क्लासेस। यू मस्ट बी नोइंग द क्लासिफिकेशन ऑफ रिएक्टिव डाइज। लेट मी टेल यू द इम्पॉर्टेंट क्लासेस लाइक मोनोक्लोरोट्रायजाइन एंड डाइक्लोरोट्रायजाइन बेस्ड डाइज, which are also known as hot brand and cold brand reactive type of dyes. Commercially, they are known as Prussian dyes. Another type of reactive dyes which is generally used for printing is vinyl sulfone dyes, which are commercially known as Ramazol type of dyes. And then bifunctional dyes like HEME type reactive dyes, which is nothing but high exhaustion, mild exhaustion type of reactive dyes. These dyes form covalent bond with cotton under alkaline condition, and that's why these are known as reactive dyes. These dyes show all-round wash and wear fastness properties like wash fastness, rubbing fastness, perspiration fastness, light fastness. All these fastness properties in case of reactive dyes are excellent, only except chlorine fastness. Now let us see printing of cotton by direct style of printing using reactive dyes. So direct style is nothing but the fabric and paste both are ready directly. We have to apply the paste on the fabric by using any method. So by using reactive dye printing paste, we have to carry out direct style of printing on cotton. But whenever the question is of reactive dyes, we have to consider one factor, that is hydrolysis of reactive dye. So what is this hydrolysis? Generally, reactive dyes have got a tendency to get hydrolyzed with the agencies which are having hydroxyl group present in their structure. So wherever hydroxyl group is present, the reactive dye gets reacted with that. So this reaction is expected generally with cellulose. Whenever we want to apply it on cotton, majority of the dye should get reacted with cellulose. But there are chances that it may get reacted with water also, that is HOH, because water also has got hydroxyl group. It may react with thickener also, because most of the thickeners consist of hydroxyl group in their structure. So whenever we prepare the print paste using reactive dye, since water is used as solvent and natural thickeners we are selecting for viscosity purpose, these both also may react with the reactive dye, and this reaction we have to avoid. In alkaline condition, this reaction will be still faster. This reaction is nothing but hydrolysis of the reactive dye. This hydrolyzed dye will cause poor wash fastness property, and under alkaline condition, rapid hydrolysis occurs. So that only we need to avoid. Let us see the mechanism of hydrolysis. Here, for example, we are taking dichlorotriazinyl based dye. So it gets reacted with cellulose, and the representative reaction is there in front of you. This is how the dye gets attached to the OH group, elimination of H, and it gets attached to the O of cellulose. So this is how it gets fixed on the cellulose substrate. But here in the second reaction, we can find that hydrolysis, how hydrolysis of reactive dye occurs. Same way the dye reacts with water, and this is how the dihydroxy group gets formed in the dye. This hydrolyzed dye gets bleeded during washing, and it causes staining of the unprinted ground also, and that's why we can again lose the print quality. We cannot get the desired percent color, cross staining may happen. And these printing faults may occur because of hydrolyzed reactive dye. Also, it causes for the poor wash fastness also. During washing, it may come out during washing and it may cause staining of the other garments also. So, let us see this. So, the reactive dye gets reacted with cellulose, thickener and water because each one of these is having hydroxyl group in their structure. So, these three reactions take place whenever reactive dye we are using. What we want is the reactive dye should get reacted with cell OH. We have to avoid its reaction with thickener. So, reactive dye thickener reaction we have to avoid. Also, reactive dye water reaction we have to avoid. These two reactions are not at all expected. Only reactive dye and cell OH, cellulose reaction is the expected one. Then only we can get the desired percent color on the fabric, the required depth of prints on the fabric. So we have to avoid another two reactions. We have to create such condition that only reactive dye and cellulose reaction should happen during steaming. So how it can be avoided? There are three ways by which we can avoid hydrolysis of the reactive dye. So very first is use of sodium alginate thickener instead of other natural thickeners to avoid dye thickener reaction. Now let me tell you that in case of sodium alginate thickener, which is obtained from the algae which grows on the sea surface water, it is again given some treatments so that hydroxyl groups in that thickener are blocked. Those are replaced. And this is how we can get sodium alginate thickener. So the hydroxyl group is replaced by ONA. And that's why we can avoid reactive dye and thickener reaction by using or by replacing other starch-based or gum thickeners by sodium alginate thickener. So it is a substitute. Second way to avoid hydrolysis of the reactive dye is use of mild oxidizing agent like resist salt in the print paste. Resist salt is nothing but sodium metanitrobenzene sulfonate. Being a mild oxidizing agent, it avoids possible hydrolysis of reactive dye due to presence of alkali in the print paste during steaming. During steaming, we know that the temperature is 102 to 105 degrees Celsius. At that temperature, since the localized dye solution is formed, the paste, the solution will be alkaline in nature. Dye fiber reactions will take place at that particular temperature and condition. There are also chances that 15 to 20% dye may get hydrolyzed under this alkaline condition as well high temperature. So this can be avoided by the addition of mild oxidizing agent. So this oxidizing agent will avoid hydrolysis of reactive dye. Hydrolysis is nothing but reduction reaction. So it avoids this reduction reaction of reactive dye. And we can get the desired color yield. Third way to avoid possible hydrolysis of reactive dye is addition of alkali just prior to printing. Now see, we are preparing the print paste. By the time entire color matching is taking place, there are chances that we may store the print paste for 6-7 hours. It depends on the accuracy of color matching. It may even lie for one day. If in the beginning itself all the ingredients are added or alkali also is added to the print paste, we are giving chances for the reactive dye to get hydrolyzed with water present in the print paste. So if alkaline condition is not there, hydrolysis will definitely take place, but it will be comparatively slower. Under alkaline condition, we know that rapid hydrolysis occurs. So if we are adding alkali just before printing to the entire printing paste, This will help to avoid hydrolysis of the reactive dye during storage of the printing paste till the program comes into existence. This is how we can avoid hydrolysis of reactive dye. Now you may say that when to add alkali during color matching. What we can do is whenever we want to do the color matching, at that time small quantity of paste except alkali, which is prepared except alkali, will be taken. In that required amount of alkali is added and then after color matching is checked. Once the color matching is okay and the program is given green signal for taking into production, then in the entire paste we can add alkali and we can start printing. So this is how we can avoid hydrolysis of the reactive dye. These are the three ways. Now let us see the essential ingredients required for reactive dye printing. Very first is dye. So reactive dye of any class we can select. Whatever is the dye, it requires alkaline condition for its fixation. Wetting agent, hygroscopic agents like urea, we can select for printing so that solubilization of the dye is enabled, as well color yield also will get improved. Alkali, now generally it is recommended that we have to make use of mild alkali like sodium carbonate or sodium bicarbonate. If we use strong alkali, the chances of hydrolysis will be increasing. So we have to go for mild alkali, and that too addition of alkali will be done just prior to printing. As earlier discussed, we have to add another ingredient, that is mild oxidizing agent like resist salt. The chemical name is sodium metanitrobenzene sulfonate. The role of resist salt is already discussed. Solvent like water, as we know that reactive dye is soluble in water, so best suitable solvent is water only. It is a universal solvent. And thickener, sodium alginate is the only option for reactive dye. So sodium alginate thickener of 5-7% concentration we can use for preparing the printing paste. Let us see the formulation. So reactive dye, X gram. Since the concentration dependent on the percent color in the design will vary, this is the general recipe. X gram quantity we have to take. Urea, 5-10% concentration we have to use. So the quantity becomes 50-100 gram per kg of the paste. Warm water should be used for dissolution of the reactive dye. So it depends 100, 200, or to maintain the viscosity of print paste. It can vary. The water quantity can vary. Resist salt as mild oxidizing agent, 1% concentration, that is 10 gram per kg of the paste we have to use. Sodium carbonate or sodium bicarbonate thickener you can choose 50-60 gram, that is 5-6% concentration. And sodium alginate thickener, 5-7% concentration paste, we can use remaining quantity to maintain appropriate viscosity of the print paste. So this is total quantity will be 1000 gram, that is 1 kg. While preparing the print paste, we have to take reactive dye, we have to add urea into it, then warm water will be added. Homogeneous paste of reactive dye is made with continuous stirring. Then after addition of resist salt is done. Once resist salt is added and it is dissolved completely, we have to add thickener into the print paste with continuous stirring so we can have proper homogeneous paste. So this paste is kept ready, and during printing we have to add sodium carbonate into the print paste. We have to get it stirred again, filtered, and then it will be taken for printing. So this is the general practice followed in the industry. Alkali addition should be done just prior to printing to avoid hydrolysis of the reactive dye during storage of the print paste. Once printing with the given paste is done, we have to follow some post-printing operations, that is processes. So after printing with the given printing paste, the fabric should be dried. It is dried properly to avoid any cross-staining for proper storage of the fabric. After drying, the fabric is taken for steaming. Steaming is done at 102 to 105 degrees Celsius for 8 to 10 minutes in the pressure steaming or in rapid edger machine, that is loop edger. For reactive dyes, the steaming duration is very less, that is 8 to 10 minutes. Since those are highly reactive, the reaction time required is very less. Once steaming is done, the fabric is washed with a series of hot and cold washes in the soaper machine. Now, as already discussed, soaper machine will be having around 7 to 8 chambers. In that, hot and cold washes series will be there in the chambers. Through that, the fabric is passed, and then after, it will be freed from the exhausted thickener film and the residual chemicals. So this is how fabric washing is done. In case of reactive dyes, the amount required of water for washing is more. After washing, an after treatment is carried out using 2 GPL non-ionic soap at boiling condition for 15 to 20 minutes. So soaping process we call it. Soaping is generally done with 2 GPL non-ionic soap for 15 to 20 minutes. Once soaping is over, the fabric is washed and dried. This is followed by washing and drying. So, let us see the process sequence for fixation of reactive prints by steaming process. There are various methods by which we can carry out fixation of reactive prints. The widely used process is steaming process, for which we have seen the post-printing operations. So the process sequence is like white and dyed fabric we can take, or white or light dyed fabric we can take. It has to be properly dried and batched, followed by printing with the paste containing alkali. So already we have seen the recipe. Alkali is added into the print paste. So the printing will be done with the help of paste containing alkali by using any suitable method, block printing, roller printing, flatbed printing, rotary screen printing, any suitable method, followed by drying of the prints. The prints should be dried properly. Then after steaming is done at 102 to 105 degrees Celsius for 8 to 10 minutes. Once steaming is done, the fabric is washed, soaping is done, followed by washing and drying. So for the steaming and soaping, we need to mention the conditions while writing in the answers. Okay. Now you may think that for which kind of dye steaming process is suitable. Steaming process is a standard process of fixation. This is suitable for all type of reactive dyes. This is suitable for even direct dyes, reactive dyes, wet dyes, acid dyes, basic dyes, all type of dyes. In case of reactives also, for all classes of reactive dyes, steaming process is suitable. And the temperature is 102 to 105, duration is 8 to 10 minutes. This is the standard for reactive dye. The second process by which fixation of reactive prints is carried out is known as dry heat process. So we have to take the fully prepared white or light dyed fabric. It should be dried and batched properly. The steps involved further are printing with the paste containing alkali, whatever formulation we have seen, with that paste we have to print the fabric, followed by drying. Then after, the fabric is taken on the stentor machine for curing purpose. Curing is done for 3 to 5 minutes, followed by washing, soaping, washing and drying. Now soaping will be done with non-ionic soap 2 to 3 GPL concentration at boiling for 15 to 20 minutes. followed by washing and drying. And the dyes which are developed by this fixation process are cold brine and hot brine. If we are taking cold brine type of reactive dyes, the curing temperature will be 100 degrees Celsius and duration will be 3 minutes. If hot brine type of reactive dyes are there, in that case, the temperature required is 140 degrees Celsius and the duration will be for 5 minutes. So this is how we can carry out curing. During curing, the reactive dye gets fixed on the textile substrate, that is cotton, at printed portion. Now one more process is there by which the reactive prints are fixed, that is called as alkali pad printing process. From the name itself, it is clear that padding with alkaline solution is done. So if we want to carry out fixation of reactive prints by this process, we have to follow these steps. Like white or light dyed fabric we have to take. It has to be dried and batched properly. The fabric is printed or printing is done with or without alkali in the printing paste. The print paste may contain sodium carbonate, sodium bicarbonate, or it can be prepared without using alkali. So this will help us to avoid hydrolysis of reactive dye if we are not adding alkali into the print paste. Then after the fabric is dried, once drying is over, the fabric is padded with 20 GPL sodium carbonate alkali solution. So this padding will help us or ensure that fixation of reactive dye is done. After padding, the fabric is dried, it is washed, soaping is done, followed by washing and drying. Now, since this is done at room temperature, this process is best suitable for cold brine type of reactive dyes only. Cold brine type of reactive dyes which are highly reactive, these will be consisting of, those are known as dichlorotriazine based dyes. Because of presence of two chlorine atoms, this is highly reactive. So it is recommended that steaming should not be done, padding also should be done at room temperature. At room temperature only during padding these dyes will get fixed. So this is how we can carry out fixation of cold brine type of reactive dyes by alkali pad printing process. For this, you will have to write down the description. Since the description is not given over here, you can write the description on your own. Next process of fixation of reactive prints is air development process. So this is the very cheaper process. Since we are carrying out development of the prints in contact with air, so there are two possible ways. Either we can carry out printing without alkali on 20 GPL sodium carbonate alkali padded fabric. So prior to printing, the fabric should be padded with alkali, that to 20 GPL carbonate solution. Means the alkali which is required for fixation of the reactive prints is present on the fabric and the print paste is free from alkali. So here we are eliminating the chances of reactive dye hydrolysis due to presence of alkali in the print paste. So we can store the paste for longer time. Or else, printing with alkali on the unpadded fabric. This possibility is also there. The print paste may consist of alkali and the regular recipe, and it can be printed on the unpadded, fully prepared fabric. Scoured, bleached, desized fabric. After printing, the fabric is hanging off for 6 to 7 hours. It is hanged off in contact with air for 6 to 7 hours. In the open width form, we have to hang the fabric so that we can ensure complete fixation, its contact with the air. So simultaneously drying of the prints also will be done. After this duration, the fabric is taken for washing. After treatment is done with non-ionic डिटर्जेंट नॉन एनिक सोप 2 GPL कॉन्सेंट्रेशन एट बॉइल कंडीशन फॉर 15 to 20 मिनट फॉलोड बाय वॉशिंग एंड ड्राइंग. Now since the air development process is there, prints are fixed by contact with air. This is also suitable for Colbrand type of reactive dyes only. So in case of Colbrand dyes, we can have good print economy because energy requirement is not over there. So friends, in this video we have seen direct cello printing using reactive dyes. How to avoid hydrolysis of the reactive dye, the significance of all the ingredients in the print paste, fixation of the reactive prints by 4 methods, that is steaming process, air development method, dry heat baking process and alkali pad printing process. These 4 methods, the suitability of dyes, all we have seen. In the next video, we will see discharge style of printing on the reactive dyed ground. Thank you.